SAP Data Unleashed is a free virtual data summit that will include significant product announcements, new demos, and an extensive live two-hour Q&A following the event. This event features speakers from SAP executive leadership team, including Jürgen Müller, Chief Technology Officer at SAP. So, register and join us on March 8, 2023 at 8 a.m. PST to understand SAP vision for data and analytics and be the first to learn about the new capabilities of SAP solutions in that area. See you on March 8th.
The SAP Cloud Application Programming Model release train keeps on chugging. We've recently received the January 2023 version update to the Cloud Application Programming Model, and it's chock full of great new functionality. In the area of Node.js, we see improvements around the typed capabilities and improved implementation of search when you're using SAP Auto Database. Java runtime sees the addition of JDK 17 support and some memory consumption improvements for large CDS models, security improvements, and other miscellaneous app new additions. On the tooling side, there's new support in Cloud Foundry for user-provided services, particularly in the case of hybrid testing. There's a whole bunch of new multi-tenancy support, and I don't have the time to go into all the details of that, but be sure to read about it in the release notes. And then finally, improvements to the Cloud Application Programming Model for deployment on Kima, in particularly the addition for HANA HDI container deployment support on the Kima runtime as well. So, as always, check out the full release notes in the description of this video. And on the subject of the Cloud Application Programming Model, our friend and former developer advocate team member, Max, has been writing quite a bit about the Cloud Application Programming Model lately. He's got a blog series that he's been working on called Surviving and Thriving with the Cloud Application Programming Model. In particular, his most recent addition to this blog series covered local development hurdles, testing and debugging with local development. Great addition to the series, great series overall. We strongly recommend that anybody out there interested in the Cloud Application Programming Model development definitely check out his blog series. Links also in the description of this video.
With the vision of the Intelligent Enterprise Suite, SAP aligns the dates on which new innovations, enhancements, and corrections of associated products are delivered so that they work as one integrated solution. SAP Analytics Cloud aligns with that global strategy for cloud application releases. The Q1 release will become available during a weekend of February 17th. Megan Hoy prepared an overview for you of what's new in SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP Digital Boardroom. While you can get all the details from Megan's blog post, let me mention a few new features. First, the new OAuth support for the Activity Log API allows you to develop fully automated solutions to fetch the logs for archival or use in another systems. Second, SAP Data Warehouse Cloud Analytics model are now supported in stories created using the optimized design experience. Third, users can now use a new data analyzer application that offers functional and usability-specific enhancements. And fourth, you can now benefit from the full set of features of Data Export Service API on the API Business Hub, including the Delta functionality. Talking about Data Export Service API, it is worth mentioning that Dave Stocker published a series of posts exploring this API. Preliminary work that you need to do in SAC, creating a basic export API wrapper in Python, expanding that wrapper with more advanced features like filters, and using the API wrapper in a Jupyter notebook. As well, remember I mentioned OAuth support for Activity Log API? Another SAP colleague, Matthew Shaw, wrote an extensive article about SAP Analytics Cloud Activities Log Command Line Interface, or CLI, to automate downloads and associated best practices. His code is available as an open source project in the SAP samples repository. He compiled a list of best practices covering many areas, including the sample script itself, the activities log in general, a bunch of FAQs, and the developer best practices when using the API. Matthew's solution uses Node.js and Postman.